Hello, my Earth Mamas. It's Marie, and I'm back for Transformation Tuesday. And today I wanted to explore the idea of daydreaming versus worrying and some strategies to help you switch gears. So first of all, both are kind of activities that our mind does when it has space. And for years, I actually kind of avoided giving my mind space because I would automatically start worrying. And so I would just keep myself really busy. That way I didn't worry. But that isn't the best way, because then what would happen was I'd get into bed and for the first time all day, I would have this, you know, think time. And so my mind would just, all of this worry would come in and I would have troubles falling asleep. And then one of the practices that I do is I pull an angel card every morning, and I would pull. And the reason I thought to share this with you guys is because I just pulled this one yesterday. Again, I pull it all the time. So it's the daydream card. And it says, you will more easily hear and receive our messages if you daydream regularly. Relax and open your mind to receiving without directing your thoughts. Just notice feelings, visions, ideas. It's the seat of creativity. So after getting this card repeatedly, so if any of you use any kind of angel cards, you'll notice that there's a frequency that'll become apparent where you just pull certain cards at a higher frequency than others. And so I was like, okay, obviously, universe is trying to tell me I need to make space for dreaming, daydreaming. So I need to play with this intersection of like the worry and the daydreaming. And I have to figure out a way to, you know, give my mind that space without falling into that worry trap. So one of the strategies that really helped, and this was a strategy that I learned through some meditation workshops that I've done over the years, and that is called labeling. So it's about noticing when you're heading down that particular thought path early on in the path. And so in meditation, the idea is to just, you know, kind of let the thoughts flow instead of like, you know, focusing. And so when I noticed that I started to worry, I would actually start to label it. And I would be like future worrying. That's where I go. Some people tend to do like past worry, where they're like worrying about things that happened in the past and they're rehashing it. So they might label it as rehashing. But because for me, I would often future worry, I would just label it future worrying. And I would just literally think about putting it in a box, you know, sort of like to the side. And I would make a deal with myself, and this actually really worked for me, and it's a strategy that you can try, as I promised I would think about that worry later, but that I was creating space for some good daydreaming right now. And by doing that, that was a really good strategy that helped me create that space for daydreaming. And I know in pregnancy, a lot of times you can have troubles with like just weird sleep patterns, right? You wake up in the middle of the night to go pee and then you fall, like come back to bed and you don't fall asleep. So if that's happening, one of the things you can do with that space is to use it for daydreaming, because daydreaming is super productive. And in our culture, we have this expectation that productivity is really tied to doing something, to doing, right? Physically doing something. And so sometimes daydreaming can feel really like almost lazy because you're not doing something. But in terms of your mental well-being, your creativity, your power for manifesting stuff in the world, daydreaming is super powerful, as long as you're not falling into worry, right? And so what I'd invite you to do is the next time that this happens, this, and I'm also thinking about this because this happened to me this morning. My husband, he gets up for work at 4:45 in the morning. And most mornings I might hear him get out of bed and that's it. But for whatever reason, this morning I heard his alarm and then I was just up. And instead of like getting into that cycle where, you know, when you're like awake and you worry now that you're not sleeping, or you worry that you're wasting time being awake and not being productive, I have learned just to reframe it as daydreaming time. And because I'm not so good at just, you know, sitting on my couch like I am right now and just making space to daydream, maybe some of you are, and that would be great. For me, I often take opportunities where in the past I would have been annoyed that I was waiting. So like if I'm in a really long line at the store and I start getting annoyed that I'm just having to wait, I think of it as, oh, this is beautiful daydreaming time. And same thing, if you wake up in the middle of the night, you're having troubles going back to bed, use it for constructive daydreaming. So constructive daydreaming is where you allow yourself just to imagine your life as you would like it. So you can imagine talking to your baby, have a whole conversation with your baby. Imagine who your baby might be. Imagine the things in the world that you're excited to share. You know, all of us have things in the world that we love. And when we have kids, one of the most joyful things about having children is that you get to share those things that you love and you get to see them take enjoyment in it too, right? And so that's something that's really fun to daydream about. Or just daydreaming about, you know, cuddling your little baby once that baby arrives, you know, earthside. So those are all really constructive daydreams. And like for me, it might be something about something that I want to try in my garden this year. That's what I was daydreaming about because I was like, well, I'm up anyway, so I might as well daydream, right? So I just had fun just like letting ideas just kind of flow. And it becomes this really enjoyable spirit time. And so this is what I'm inviting you to do. And then if the worries come back, every time you start to notice that you're instead of just like creatively daydreaming, which feels really good, you'll know the difference. Because creatively daydreaming, it always feels good. Worrying feels bad, really uncomfortable. So it's pretty quick you'll notice. So and the more you practice this, actually, the faster you'll get at noticing when you head down that worry path and be able to like just redirect. And so every time that happens, just with kindness towards yourself, you're just going to label it as, oh, that's worries. You're just going to go and put it in your box. And if you're someone who has any kind of spiritual tradition, I would recommend that you give the worry away. Whether you just give it to the universe, you give it to universal love, you give it to Jesus, you give it to a guardian angel, you give it to a spirit guide, you give it to your ancestors, your grandmother who's looking out for you. Whatever makes sense in your worldview and your spirituality, give it. Almost all spiritual traditions have that practice of like, you don't have to carry that weight of those worries. You can give them to that higher power. So if that makes sense for your world beliefs, that is an awesome way. And it's super, super powerful. And I'm very much of the experiential belief. So I love to give you suggestions to help you just, you know, improve, up-level that experience of your pregnancy. But for sure, I want you to go and experiment with them. Try them out. And if they work for you, then take them in, right? And if they don't, just let it go. And that's okay. Because we're all different. And, you know, some things work for some and not for others. So I hope this has been helpful. I hope this gives you a little bit of clarity. And oh, I was going to answer one more really nice place to daydream outside of, you know, in bed or in a line is out in nature. Any sort of repetitive movement that you do in nature is prime daydreaming, fertile ground. So if you live in the north like me, maybe that's cross-country skiing, or maybe it's simply just going for a walk because, you know, cross-country skis and a belly, that can get complicated. But going for a walk, that's an activity that's really accessible throughout the whole pregnancy. You just have to, you know, moderate your length and your speed depending on where you are, how you're feeling. But generally, it's something that's accessible. And so as you're just outside in nature, just try it. Just try daydreaming and just let your thoughts just flow, like it says, right? Seed of creativity, relax, open your mind to receiving without directing your thoughts. noticing any feelings, any ideas, as though you were simply just watching a movie in your mind. So that is that's my wish for you this week, is to play with daydreaming. If anyone would like to know the kind of cards that I use, let me know. I'll post it below. All the best. See you next time.